Greetings, minions. Today we are having a new game called Prison Simulator. We are going to actually start a new game. And we're going to start on the middle one, Sergeant, so confirm that. Now we need to make it. So we're going to call it, I think, YouTube Prison. Okay. Welcome to the Prison Creator. Here you can choose the appearance of your convict. On the right, there are options to customize your prisoner's first and last name and change their voice configuration. Also on the right, you can customize the prisoner's body, face, and skin tone. When your prisoner is ready, press confirm. If you don't want to choose how your prisoner looks, just press random and then continue. I think that's what we'll do. You don't have to manually create each prisoner or randomize button. We'll randomize the name, appearance, and voice of all the remaining prisoners. This won't change the prisoners you already have customized. You can still customize the randomly generated prisoners by selecting their name on the list. Remember to press confirm when you are done. Press the continue button when you are finished. Okay, so yeah, I think we're just gonna hit randomize all. There you go, done. So, toy store robbery, stealing a thoroughbred cat, pretended to be a grandson of an elderly people, possession of three. Oh my god, there's lots of. Wow. Okay. Finish. In the gang creator, you choose who joins one of the three gangs. You can choose a symbol for each gang. Press on the plus icon to choose one of the available symbols. Enter a name for the gang below the icon. 16 characters. Sure. You can add prisoners to each gang as you like. I think we're just going to randomize it again. We're just going to randomize all, and it does not. Finish. So I just want to put a disclaimer. Anything you see or hear in this game is purely in the game. Let's see how we do. This is a real long intro. Oh my god, he had purple eyes and mouth. What the hell? That dartboard is not that big. Alright, I'm just going to skip this because it takes too long. Alright, welcome to the Prison Simulator. To follow updates or report bugs, please join our Discord. We're already in the Discord. Your main task is carry out the routines assigned to you for the day. Check their list in the journal before, during the day. React to prisoners' bad behavior either by talking to them or by using force. And between routines, you free time to spend fun. Most of your actions are evaluated by other guards and prisoners. Affects your level of respect. The overall level of respect is the average of your individual relationship with the prisoners. During your free time, you can relax by playing mini games, doing side quests, or reacting to in-game events. Okay, so first, he's talked to the guard. I'm Richard, nice to meet you. Hi Richard. So, do you have any questions before we go to the warden? Can you tell me something about the prison? Well, it's like any other prison. Dangerous, if you're not careful. One day an inmate acts normal, the other day he stabs you with a shank. You can't trust him. But there are some pros too, like we have a really nice social room. Where you can rest and drink coffee or play some darts. Oh, did you heard about the last riot? So This has got some very bad English in it, I'm just saying. I know that maybe they tried to translate it as best they could, but it's got some very bad grammar and English in it. No.
Inguguma,
a few months ago, there was a big riot. The prisoners managed to open all the cells and were trying to take over the facility. It was exactly the day after the new officer arrived, you think. What an unlucky guy to have a riot next day after starting on duty. But turns out that it was the prisoners who were the unlucky guy. That guy was like a one-man army. Or like John Wick. From that action movie. Where bad guys killed his cat and he managed to end the riot almost alone. John Wick. I love it. And a few days after that, there was a blackout and he saved the day again. That was a great guy. What happened to him? He's not working here anymore. He had some disagreement with a warden. I think it was about money. Anyway, any more questions? No, I think I'm good. We'll just go to the ward. Oh, one more thing. If you feel lost, use your maps under the M button or whichever. I hope you took your basic equipment from the locker. You can equip yourself with mouse scroll or under 1-7 button. Ready? Follow me. The first Q, you can get your list. You've got no hands. You've got clicker, truncheon, or nightstick, walkie-talkie. I think this is like CS gas, taser, gun, and I don't know what these two are yet. Oh, yeah, we don't want to pull our fists out. Eight minutes in, we've barely started. Into the warden's office. Oh, you must be the new guy. I'm Kenneth, your new warden. Nice to meet you. How are you feeling? Nervous, huh? I'm good, sir. I'm glad to hear that. Confidence is really important here, and you don't bother with formality. You can call me Mr. Warden. Okay, let's go back to business. Here's your duties for today. You can check them in your journal. It was J button, if I recall. You can read there what has to be done. I'll mark it on your map where you should go first. And after each routine, you have free time. So you can rest a bit, or check out the facility, or just relax. We have a nice social room with coffee and stuff. When you're done with your duties, go to the briefing room to report your day. And I think that's all. Any questions? No. I think I'm good. Great, now you can go. Good luck. Okay, quest one done. Okay, go to the cell block. Down here, and you can buy some food if you need. Eating restores your hit point. Go to the vending machine and choose something. Pick what you like to have with default left mouse button, select the quantity and confirm. Or take your food in hand, open your inventory. Yeah, you just put stuff in your inventory for later. We have to make sure we shut the door, actually. We don't have to shut the door. These guards walking around will actually shut the doors for you. You look really open. Door will get shut. Right, your first task is check the attendance. Go to the duty office, which is to the left of the entrance. Use the lever to open the cells. Choose the clicker. Go to each of the prisoners. Count them with left mouse button. When a prisoner does not go to the assembly, speak to him to find out why he's not cooperating. React when prisoners are not behaving properly. Use one of the tools of direct force. Choose the weapon for inflection. Go in here. And then we open this. We best shut this again because there is a gun in there. And now we have to just... If a prisoner does not stick to the rules, he should be punished. But first you need to pacify him with a nightstick or a taser. In some cases, a talk is enough. Usually not. Select the walkie-talkie default cue. Go to the aggressive person. Use the walkie-talkie and choose one of the available punishments. The prisoner will get a penalty marker over his head. The prisoner can't be punished anymore today. If you choose solitary confinement as a punishment, talk to the prisoner after you have finished your routine and take him to the marked solitary cell, then lock. Okay, he's fine. Oh no, we've got a punch up already. This is your primary tool of direct force. You can't kill with it, but you can pacify the problem prisoner. To attack, press the left mouse button. To form a strong attack, hold down the left mouse button. Attacking and blocking uses stamina. Oh god, they've all started.
Oh, come on.
Right, you two. We'll give you punishment in a minute. We click that guy. We have to click this fella. And click this guy. And this one. This one. This one. This one. This one. Apart from those two, everyone seems to be behaving. Apparently we missed one. Where? What one did we miss? Oh, you. Hi, you're not... At roll call, you're supposed to stand in front of yourself. Why is that? I'm here. I didn't run anywhere. What's the point of all that roll call when you're counting? I'm not the one who made the rules, but you're supposed to follow them. What bullshit? Can't you just check me? I'm here. I'm in my cell. I didn't fucking run anywhere. Roll call keeps order. Yeah, right. And what about those clickers? You can't count to 10 in your head. Do you want to stay in your cell for the rest of the day or what? Yeah, no more arguments. Better to start threatening me. Coming. Okay, task complete. Now it's your free time. You can play mini games or do some side quests. When you notice that someone has an exclamation point above their head, it means they have a quest for you. By doing side quests, you can earn money and gain respect. Other icons like fists or clouds are connected to tasks which you have to complete. Beat someone up. Character with a fist icon, or talk to somebody. Cloud icon. That's not clouds, that's handshake. More on those in the tutorial. The icon above the fish's head means that you complete your task, you can talk to him about your payment. Check the map to see where you can find mini games and side quests. And skip your free time by interacting with the available benches in the hall. After a second, you'll be able to start the next routine from your day plan. Okay. Should we punish these, or should we leave them? I mean, they got a bit of a beating, and you're not even... Excuse me, you're not even peeing... You've peed on the floor. Such a bad shot. Such a bad shot. Alright, let's lock them back up. And we'll go to free time. Should we go to... You know what, let's go to... that's solitary. I went the wrong way. Let's go to the gun range. Show you the gun range. So the gun range is over here. Shooting range. Welcome to the shooting range. Here you can relax by training your aim. Go to the next selected stand to start. Every stand has a different game mode. Choose one of the available weapons and shoot targets according to the rules. Because every stand has a different game mode, but there's no weapon on here. There's also no weapon on here. Or here, or here. There's only a weapon on here. Okay, stand one. Alright, let's go a riot gun. Aim by moving the mouse, take a shot, press hold left mouse button, right button to switch aiming mode. When all the ammunition is expended, the weapon reload automatically. You zoom in, and then you left click to fire. It's not very accurate, this weapon. I mean, clearly they are headshots, but... percent accuracy. Clearly some of them misfired too, like they didn't hit right, but 100% accuracy. Here you go. Free time is complete. And these are all the weapons. Grenade launchers, riot stuff. Make sure that's shut. Go to the parcel searching room. Don't know if we've got time for this, but we'll give it a go. Alright, parcel searching. During this routine, you have to check the contents of packages for illegal contraband. Go to the shelf and take a package by default, and then put it on the table. To begin searching, open the lid. Pick up an item from the box. Right, so basically, I'm not going to go through this all because it takes too long. You open the boxes like this. Pick up an item, press E, right click to open it up like this, and then you look for anything, any contraband. Press E to put it back. You're happy. Okay, nothing there. Look, we found a joint. Where are you going to take the joint in this occasion? And a razor blade. Oh my god, we're going to secure the razor blade. Okay, that one's done. Make another box, open it. I see nothing. I see nothing. Nothing. Don't see anything there. Contraband, drugs. Let's take the drugs. No one notices. And nothing in that one. Okay, that one's clean. Did I mention that I'm not necessarily going to be a good guard all the time? Like, we might end up stealing a bit of contraband every now and then, because we need something to trade with the prisoners. Pills? Yeah, sure. Book. I see nothing in the book. Right, this should be done. Okay, if you complete all your planned routines and it merges, you go to the briefing room at the end of the day. Okay. I think it's through here. So you've got things like the visiting room, which isn't unlocked until level 8. That's the locker room that we came out of. There's the guard room. This is the guard's room. Here you and your friends can rest. Look for available entertainment like playing cards or darts. I haven't seen cards, actually, but I have seen darts. Well, maybe the dartboard was bigger than I thought. All right. And then on here, these are players that, like most pacified prisoners with a taser this month. So Knox has done 418. Kind of funny. 418 pacified with a taser in the last month. But they're here, see? And then bad guards, Knox, most pacified guards this month. Knox 100. So you can get your name on the leaderboards. It's pretty funny. Briefing.
I guess in high, I care.
So, ready for your daily report? Yeah, it's over for today. So we made level 2. We made $10. We got 6% guard rep. Oh, we done all right. I mean, we done what we was meant to do, right?
That's an advent hardy, huh?
And reload for the next day. Okay, so at this point, time's up. Thank you for watching. We'll start right off from here for the next episode. And we'll get into it. Bye.